Once our project is created, we are taken to Visual Studio's working area. And this is the default area that can be modified. You can move these items around. And you can see that there is a lot going on here. A few different windows, many buttons, and many tabs. And that's because this is the tool to write professional code. So if you go to a company and sit on a working station of a professional developer that uses Visual Studio, this is exactly what you see. So this is a professional tool. That's why it has so many features, but I'm not going to teach you everything right now. It's better if you learn them as you go, as you need them. I'm a strong believer in learning by practice, and you'll only retain the things that you are using. And the first couple of things that you need to learn here and that you will definitely be using are the Solution Explorer window and the Files window. So on the right, you can see the Solution Explorer with all the files contained in that project. And on the left, you have a tab with the program.cs, which is one of the files of this application. And you can have many of those tabs open, and that's where your code is written. That's where you're going to spend most of your time as a C# developer. And with .NET, whenever we create a new project, .NET ships a program ready to be used. And in this case, it's a very simple program that will print hello world to a command line prompt. We're going to dive into the syntax in a moment, but first, let's just have a look at the files that were shipped with this project. So one of these files is the program.cs, which is the starting point of our application. And we're going to learn what this CS is in a moment. Then we have a my first program file. And this file contains information about how this project will be run, but we also don't need to dive too deep into it right now. And we can see that there is a dependencies folder. This is not a real folder. It's just a visual feature by Visual Studio for us to see any pre-written code that we bring into our project. So in this area, we're going to have information about the frameworks that this project is running on and any libraries that we use in this project. We're going to dive deeper into libraries later. All you need to know right now is that in most C# applications, we bring in code written by other developers. We're not always writing everything from scratch, and we call these pieces of code libraries. They can be provided by Microsoft, but most of them are created by the huge community of C# developers out there. And before we test the app to see what it does, let's go into our file explorer so we can actually see the files in our computer. So if you go into the folder where your project is, the first thing you can see is a .sln file. And this is a file that keeps information about the organization of projects in a solution file. So that means that a solution can have multiple projects that are responsible for different things. And the main purpose of this is organization. This is one of the reasons I love C# so much. It has fantastic tools to keep our projects organized. And in the current version of Visual Studio, we can't open the SLN file. So here I'm right-clicking on the file and opening it with a notepad. And I can see a lot of text here that seems very verbose, but don't worry, we don't need to understand it at this stage. But if you do want to dive deeper already into each of these files, there are reference links in the descriptions below. If you go into your project's folder, you can see the My First Program file. So that's a csproj file. And you can also see your program.cs in a couple of folders where your project builds and runs your program. And you can't see these folders in Visual Studio. Back in Visual Studio, let's finally run the program by clicking on the green arrow with the name of the program, which is in this case, My First Program. And here we can straight away learn about a couple more features of Visual Studio. We have this output window just below the files window. And the purpose of this window is basically to tell us what's going on when we run our app. And that's also the window where we are going to see any errors. So that's something that we're going to be using a lot to solve any problems that might happen when we're developing. And then on the right side, you can see a properties window. And that's where you can see the properties of the file that you highlighted. In this case, we can see a couple of properties of the myfirstprogram.cs project. Then we can finally see the result of running our app. It's a very simple app that prints hello world. And I know that that's not very exciting. It's not a fancy program, but still, it's the first moment where you told a computer to do something automatically by the click of a button. So you should celebrate. This is your first program. All the best developers in the world wrote their first program at some point. Bill Gates did it. So write down this moment in a calendar, put it somewhere where you're going to remember, and one day you're going to look back at this moment and have great memories about it.